Hey, what's up guys? This is Dan Duran. I hope you're doing fantastic. At the end of this video, you're going to be able to do this. You're going to be able to run a Kali operating system side by side two Windows machines in a completely enclosed environment for penetration testing and ethical hacking. The best part about this is that you're going to be using software that you already have. Pretty cool, right? So now get your coffee and let's get going. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is to make sure that you have the right edition of Windows 10 or 11 installed on your computer. Let's do that. So right here on your documents, just click, go to this PC, right click, properties, and then on the second tab, you'll see Windows specifications, and this is the edition that you're running. If you're running the home edition, make sure you click on the link below to install VirtualBox instead. The second thing you need to do is go into your search bar, type in control panel like that. Once you see the screen here, type in features. You'll see turn Windows features on and off. Click on that link. Once you see the features box, go all the way down to Hyper-V and make sure this is selected. Then click OK. Once you apply the changes, all you have to do is restart your computer. Now, this process might take probably 3 to 5 minutes, so don't worry. Just wait until your computer restarts and I'll see you in a bit. All right, I'm back. So now what you have to do is go into your search and type in Hyper-V Manager. Click on Hyper-V Manager. Like so, you see this window here. Click on Action, Quick Create. And then from here, I want you to install the Windows 11 development environment. Like so, and click on create virtual machine. There you go. In the meantime, what you can do is go into your browser and let's download the Kali machine. Type in Kali downloads and go to kali.org/getkali. From here, click on bare metal. Go all the way down to 64-bit and click on the installer like this. And now we just wait. All right, perfect. So now it's just verifying the image and now it's creating the virtual machine for you. So once you're done with this, then you'll see this little screen that says virtual machine created successfully. As you can see, I already have a few machines in here. So what I'm going to do now is install the Kali Linux machine. Go to Actions once again, click on Quick Create. And then in here, I want you to click on Local Installation Source. And then from here, unclick this virtual machine will run on Windows. Click on Change Installation Source. And from here, I want you to go to Downloads and click on the Kali Linux ISO and then create virtual machine. So now the virtual machine was created successfully. Once this is done, click on Settings and let's walk through the settings. Just leave everything the way it is on firmware, security, and memory. Make sure this is 2 gigabytes of RAM. And then in here, if you want, you can type in 4096. On processor, I'm going to put 4 processors as opposed to 8. And then in hard drive, I leave everything the way it is. And then in network adapter, leave it as default switch. I'll show you how to create a new network after we're done. apply this and click OK. And now click on connect. Click on start. And click on graphical install. English, United States, American English. Here, the host name is going to be Cali. The domain name is going to be Cali. The user is going to be Cali as well. And the password is going to be Cali. Eastern. Click on guided. Continue. All files in one partition. And finished. Click on yes. Okay, from here, just click on continue. All right, once it's finished, click on continue. And the Cali system is going to start booting up. There's a couple more things that we need to do in here. All right, get into the Cali system. Like that. Now open a terminal. Type in sudo su. Enter your password. And from here, what we're going to do is make your screen the same size as your monitor. So 1920 by 1080. Type in nano etc default. Grub. In here, go to grub cmd line Linux default, and after quiet, type in splash video hyper-v underscore fb colon 1920 by 1080. Like this. Then type control X to exit, and then Y for saving. From here, type in update-grub to update the grub, and then type reboot. And now your Cali system is going to be the size of your entire monitor. We have this done. Now let's set up the Windows machine. So we already installed the Windows machine in here. So click on settings, like this. Let's rename it to whatever you want to rename it. So Windows 11-1 for me. In firmware, leave this the way it is. Same with security, same with memory. And then let's change this to 4096. Processor, I'm going to change this to 4 processors. Leave everything the way it is. And click apply. Now, okay. And then double click on your Windows machine. Like this. Click on start. And here you can make the size of the resolution for your Windows machine as big or as small as you want. In my case, I'm going to bring it down to the smallest. Click on connect. And there you go. You're actually on your Windows 11 environment. Now let's look at the IP addresses and if we have connection to the internet. Go into search, type CMD, type traceroute.google.com. As you can see, we do have access to the internet. CLS to clear the screen. Now type in ipconfig. Now this is your IP address. Now let's go back to the Cali machine. And let's repeat the same process. Click on terminal. In here, do a traceroute. Google.com. As you can see, we already have access to the internet. Control L to clear the screen. Type in IPA. As you can see, your IP address is different in a different subnet than your Windows machine. So this one here is 156.49 and this one over here is 148. So now we're going to create a new network for these two computers. So let's shut off these machines, both of them. Let's make sure that they're completely off. In the meantime, I'm just going to rename this machine. Kali new. There you go. All right, so let's create a new virtual switch. Right click on your computer. Click on Virtual Switch Manager. From here, click on External and create a virtual switch. Just name it. I'm going to name it Network 3. And here in VLAN ID, enable Virtual LAN Identification. From here, you can select your controller. In my case, I'm going to select controller 2 and click on apply. Click OK. Now you have to apply the settings to your new virtual machines. On my Kali New, I'm going to go into settings. And right here in network adapter, I'm going to choose network 3, like that. Apply. And same with my Windows machine. Go to settings, network adapter, network 3, and apply. Now let's start up these machines. Double click on Kali New. And let's double click on the Windows machine. Okay, I'm going to log into my Kali. Maximize. Let's go to the terminal. IPA. And you see that my IP address has changed. Do the same with your Windows VM. Search CMD. ipconfig. Now you'll see that the machine is in the same subnet. Now all you have to do is just repeat the process for creating another VM. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you have fun. If you have any questions or any comments, make sure you post them down below, and I hope to see you next time. Stay safe, stay secure.